Hello, hello, hello. Good morning, good morning, good morning. Good morning, everybody. Good morning, good morning. Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, and today's Thursday. Missing in action for 3 days. Don't worry, don't worry, I'll explain. Good morning to you. Good morning. This is the day the Lord hath made. We will rejoice and be glad in it. Magnify the Lord with me. Let us exalt his name together. I sought the Lord and he heard me and delivered me from all my fears. It's the 19th day of August 2021. Time now is 19 minutes after 7 o'clock. Good morning, good morning. From Negro Point to Moran Point. All across the United States of America, New York City to be exact. Good morning, manna in the morning. All right. Go all the way up to 10 o'clock this morning. 10 o'clock this morning, all right? Full 3 hours. All right, everybody. We need to talk. We need to talk. All right, so let's get to it. Let's get to it. Praise the name of the Lord. Praise the name of the Lord. Glad to be back with you again. The truth of the matter is I've been trying to get back to you from Monday, Tuesday morning. But I started back working, and my schedule is like I start work like in the afternoon. In the afternoon, I start to work, and then I normally do 12, sometimes 14 hours when I go to work. So that would go on until 3, 2, 3, 4 in the morning. That's the time I normally come home sometimes. Sometimes even 5, 6 o'clock in the morning, I get home. So when I come home, I tell myself, okay, I only have 2 hours sleep before ear time, or I only have an hour sleep, or I only have half. It depends on what time I get home. But sometimes it's 2 hours, sometimes it's 3 hours, sometimes it's 4 hours. Depends on what time I reach home in the mornings. And then I tell myself I'm gonna get me a little bit of nap before studio time, before air time, and then the little nap, a little nap turned out into a gorilla nap. Instead of a little baby nap, it becomes a elephant nap, a big old nap that napped me out. So that's what has been happening for the most part. While you haven't been hearing from me, my schedule has changed. I normally work at night, and I come home in the morning to get my sleep throughout. From in the mornings to early afternoon, I wake up maybe 1 o'clock, 2 o'clock, and then get ready to go to work and come back again 2, 3 o'clock in the morning. I come home. So that has been my routine now for a number of years. And then I got back to work last week. Thursday I went back to work, and ever since then it messes up my normal schedule with you. But I promise you, by the grace of, even though the devil tried me this morning again to knock me out this morning again, but thank God to those of you that keep a brisk and get me up and get me out and get me going. But I'm going to fight back. I'm not going to let this thing overtake me anymore. I'm going to resist as hard as I can, which is very difficult, because when you work for 12, 13, 14 hours straight, and to come and do a radio show right after that, it yeah. But the thing with me is this: once I am up, I'm up. Once I am up and I'm going, then everything is okay. But the point is to get up and get going. So again, I sincerely apologize for Monday, Tuesday, and Wednesday. Here am I with you on Thursday, and there's just so much to cover in terms of plans that we have for this weekend. We start the revival on Friday evening at 7 o'clock. Friday, Saturday, Sunday, 3 nights of revival over there by House of Prayer by Pastor Blake's church. We're going to use his facilities to do this service, and so we're going to be there for 3 nights, and I'm going to be preaching for those 3 nights. We are supposed to be airing these things on the internet, on the app. We're going to be streaming live on the app. Today we're supposed to go by the church to do some checks. So we intend to go by the church today to do some checks, and meaning plug in the computers and make sure everything is working properly, and we intend to do that today. So everybody, I'm very, very happy to be back with you this morning. Believe me, I'm really very happy to be back. In the mornings when I get up late, sometimes 7 o'clock, sometimes after 8, and I realize I missed the program, I am so upset, I'm so angry, irritable that I missed the program. But you know, the body is a thing called the body, the human body. And the body does its own thing sometimes. I'm telling you, sleep is one of them that when the body needs to rest, it will take it. Yeah? It will take that rest with or without your permission. It will do that. And then because of the kind of job that I do, it is very important that I get proper rest. Because when I'm working, I got to be on my cues. I got to be sharp in terms of my awareness. It has to be quick and sharp when I'm working because of the kind of job that I do. Again, I'm glad to be back with you. Let me not talk too much. Let's move on and get to the music and get into some prayer and let God have his way. Again, good morning to you. Welcome on board. The blessing of the Lord be with you. And I'm glad that you are there and that we are here together. And we just give God thanks and praise for all that he has done, all that he's doing.
Oh my God, oh my God, glory, I stand in reverence of your glory, words fail to capture all you show me. Never sing my love for you. Oh, I've tasted. I'll tell the world of what I've tasted. Your goodness towards me won't be wasted. I'll never sing my love for you. Your grace towards me makes me worthy. I'll never sing my love for you. Oh, 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 won't seem forever. Crumb, silence the roaring thunder. You are the God of wonders. Oh my God.
Good morning to you. It's Manna in the morning. Pastor Howard Palmer here with you. Telling you. Oh my God. I tell you, I've been listening to some new music, man. I'm ready for you. My God. Blessing of the Lord rest upon you. From the crown of your head. to the soles of your feet. What a God, what a God, what a wonderful Savior, blessed Redeemer. Oh, oh my God. Good morning. Aha. Oh my God. Oh, oh my God.
What you've done.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, 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 oh my God.
Oh my God.
That's who.
You took the keys forever. You took the keys forever. The key of death and hell. Mm-hmm. You conquered the powers of darkness. You gave us the victory. Jesus, there's none like you. Nobody like you, Lord. Nobody like you. Let's continue with the music. Tasha Combs, I love it. Beautiful songs, beautiful sounds.
Fearfully, wonderfully, made in the image of Abba, I am free, completely, safe in the arms of my Father. I am royalty, I am who you call me, I believe, I am. Fearfully, wonderfully, made in the image of Abba, I am free, completely, safe in the arms of my Father. I am royalty. Peace, a knock before life ever started. You took your time on me. I'm royalty, and my Father is King. I believe I am yours.
I'm not an accident, nor a coincidence. I was made on purpose. You know what that means? It means he wanted me here. God wanted you here. He made you on purpose. On purpose, he wanted you here. Yes, he did. No accident, no coincidence. He's able to do exceeding abundantly above all we're able to ask or think.
You made me on purpose, and I am
your favorite.
You made me on purpose. You gotta declare it over your life.
To see, help me to see, Lord, open my eyes to see. You made me on purpose. Good morning. I'm not an accident nor a coincidence. Even if my mama and my papa didn't want me here, I'm not an accident. I'm a designer's original, divinely designed to be here. I was born to be here. I was born to do what I'm doing. Purpose and destiny is on my life. I said purpose and destiny. Destiny is just a fancy word for destination. Yeah. Purpose is God's plan. That's what the word purpose means. It means a plan. God has a plan for my life. And he couples that with time and destiny. So God determined what year I would be born. Based on Romans chapter 1, he said, the Bible says, am I right there? No. Acts chapter 17, 26. He said, before time, he has appointed our boundary and our abode of habitation. That's what the Bible said in it. I tell you, I love that word of God. I love that word of God. I gotta take this from the top one more time. The Bible said, you know what the Bible said? Of one blood, he hath made all nations of men to dwell on the face of the earth, and before time hath appointed their boundary and their place of habitation. Can you imagine that? Let me take my time again. Are we just going to relax this morning and just go with the flow, all right? The Bible said in Acts chapter 17, verse 26, that God, by one blood, through one blood, he hath made all nations of men. Through one blood, you know. Through one blood, he hath made all nations of men to dwell upon the face of the earth, and before time hath appointed their boundary and their place of habitation. Before time he has determined their boundary. So God placed the human family, the human race, in strategic areas of the world and put a boundary there. In most cases, you know what God used to draw the boundary? The ocean, mountains, and then there are some countries that are joined by land. For instance, if you think of some countries in Africa, the people are joined by they are connected by the land. There's a land mass there. There's no ocean between them, just land. But over this side they speak one language, and over the other side they speak another language. So you use language and sometimes the ocean and sometimes mountains to draw boundaries. That always amazes me. How can there be two group of people, or sometimes more than two groups, and they are joined by land? There's no water, no body of water between them. But yet they speak different languages. And it's just, I'm seeing my neighbor every day. They're speaking a language over there, and I'm speaking a different language over here. That's what the Bible said. Can we talk this morning? Oh God. Let's enjoy this while we talk.
I am
So the Bible says he used one blood to make all nations of men to dwell on the face of the earth, and before time hath appointed their boundaries and their places of habitation. God put a boundary. See, going to Africa, as I said before, they speak in many different languages in Africa. Villages and various communities separated by languages and what we call dialects. You go to Europe, Germany and France is joined by land. Most of the European continent is joined by land mass. And yet right over here they speak French, and over here they speak German. Just by land, you could walk from one place to the other. But the Bible says that God appointed their boundary and their places of habitation. He determined, listen this, the scripture says he determines our times, T-I-M-E-S. God determines our times. That's a very powerful statement from the Bible. The scripture said God determined our times. Our times. What does it mean by your times? All right, let's look at it. The word times there speaks of a specific period in time, a specific moment in time, specific moment in time. At a specific moment in time, you were born. You were born into this world. So there was a time when you weren't born. There was a time when you were conceived. There was a time when you weren't even conceived. But as time progresses, manifestation of your existence begin to take place. Till one day your mother declare, "I'm pregnant." And you begin to grow in the womb until the day came at a particular moment in time. You were born into this world, and the doctors recorded the day, the time when you took your first breath on this side of the Jordan. No, you're alive. You are now in existence. But there was somebody planned your entrance into this world before you came. Before we came into this world, somebody bigger than you and I planned our arrival. This one that of which I speak is why I praise him and worship him. When my heart gets close to God, I'm the happiest I have ever been. I'm the happiest when my spirit draws close to God and I sense his presence. That's when I'm at my top, my peak. Because it's a wonderful thing to feel your maker close to you, close to your heart, close to your spirit. The nearness of your maker, this God who planned my days, who planned, according to Acts 17, he planned my times, he planned my boundaries, he planned my place of habitation, where on the planet I would live. And what my boundaries would be, which means my daily travel, my daily activity would cover a certain radius of space. Do you understand what I'm trying to say? Think about your life. Watch this. Where you work, where you live, where you go to church, where you shop consistently is within a certain radius of space. Maybe a 5-mile radius, 10-mile radius. If you got to go to the supermarket, that's where you go. If you got to go to the post office, that's where you go. If you got to go to the bank, that's where you go. If you got to go to work, that's where you go. It is a 5, 10, 15-mile radius that you frequent. I know we don't think about this enough, but even this is in the Bible. Am I talking to myself, my God? Lord, am I talking to myself? Hello. Do you know that your daily travel, your daily back and forth, your daily activity it is within a certain space. It's just within a certain confinement of space. You calculate the distance from your house to the bank, the distance from your house to your job, the distance from your house to church, the distance from your house to wherever you go is within a certain radius, certain space. You understand me? 5 mile radius, 10 mile, 15 mile radius. That's your boundary. That is your boundary and place of habitation. It doesn't mean you can't go beyond that. You know, we do go on vacation, we travel, go far places, etc. But where your spirit settled for now is within that radius of space. Do you understand what I'm telling you? Where your spirit settled and called home. I did not know. That where I live now or within the area that I occupy between Long Island, Queens and Brooklyn. That's my space right there in Manhattan and Bronx within that radius. That is my daily travel because of work, because of contacts and this and that. That's within my radius space, about 20, 25, 30 miles radius. Including work, take up most of that circumference of space. But what I'm trying to get across to you is that's in the Bible. God, through one blood, made all nations of men. He has before time appointed, determined our times and our place and our boundary of habitation. He determine your times and boundaries of habitation. So let's deal with times. Your time speaks of at what particular time in the advent of human history you would be born. God determined that. Bakoba Shata. The Bible said, oh God, I'm gonna love this tape. I'm gonna have to watch this over again. You hear what the Bible said? The Bible clearly teaches us, right, that God told Jeremiah, he said, before I formed you in the belly, I knew you. I cannot get over that scripture. That scripture has been there. I can't get over it. Before I formed you in your mother's belly, I said, I knew you. The question is, remember I told you, I'm just going to flow with you this morning. That's it. Flow with the Spirit this morning. Before I form you, physical, think about your physical, biological formation. God said, before I form you in the belly, I knew you. So that is taking us now beyond time now, that you have time, that's where we live. Earth, governed by the four seasons, spring, fall, summer, winter. Controlled by the sun. The sun regulates the seasons on earth. And within the confine of seasons, you have time, which is the key. Time that governs our activity on earth here. Time determine what clothes I wear, at what point of the year. All this stuff, time. But where God lives, where God exists, God's realm that he occupies, is not. There's no time there. It's eternity. That's why the Bible said in Revelation, there's no sun there, no moon. There's no sun, no moon, no night, no day. Because he is the light. Do you understand what I'm saying? So now where we live here on this earth is governed by time. So God determined my times according to the Bible. At what particular time in the course of human history I would be born? God determines that. God determines my times. I want you to be born at this particular time. But hear what the scripture says. He said, I knew you before you were born. Before you were born. Before I formed you. He didn't say born, sorry. He said, before I form you, I knew you. So this is telling us that God has record of me before I was formed. Meaning, before I entered my mother's womb, God had a record of me. Can I tell you something? God, Elohim,
has a record of you before you were formed in your mother's belly. He has a historical record of you. Yes, I'm saying it. That's what I'm saying. You existed before you entered your mother's womb. You existed before you entered your mother's womb. I am sure about it. I have scripture. He said, where was I? Where was I? You were in the mind of God, not just in the mind of God. You existed with God in eternity past. Pastor Palma, how do you know this? Because the Bible said he is the father of all spirits. God is the father of all spirits. What does this mean? It means that spirit being cannot die. From spirit beings were created as spirit, which we don't know when that was. You don't hear me? The Bible said God is the father of all spirits, plural. So spirits are defined in a couple of categories. The angels are spirit, demons are spirit, human being has a spirit, then you have the spirit of the devil, then you have the spirit of God. God the Father says he is the father of all spirits. He made all spirits. He made human being spirit. He made the devil. He made the angels. He made the fallen angels. All of this stuff, God did it. So in eternity past, listen to what I'm about to tell you, because I'm taking you into deep waters to this morning. Watch this. In eternity past, at some point in eternity past, God made your spirit. That's what the Bible said. In the beginning, God created the heaven and the earth. One scripture said he formed man. One scripture said he made man. Another scripture said he created man. One of these, they're going to do a teaching on that. One scripture said he formed man from the dust of the ground. Another scripture said he created man. And another scripture said he make man. Why is the Bible saying all of that? I don't want to get off into that. God, that's too much. And I cannot talk about these things without scripture. And I don't have it all in my head. But just believe me, it's there. And God created man. And then he says he formed man. Then it says he make man. Why is the scripture using these different words? You see, when God created man, it's different from when God formed man. When he formed man is when he literally took the dirt and formed you from the dirt. But that was the last, that was the final, that was the final, result. He created you before he formed you. Did you know that? I need to get my scriptures going for this. I can easily talk off the top of my head, but these are too deep of a water to just talk off of my head. I need scripture. I need to have my scriptures before me. Because you're going to be saying, yeah, I need scripture. I'm telling you. God created you before he formed you. Form you was the last part of it. He created you, then he make you, then he form you. Did you know you read that all the time? It's in the Bible. Did you know you have read that many times? He created you, then he make you, then he form you. Form is when he literally went down there to the ground and carved you out of mud. We will get there. We'll get there another time. But I'm trying to say, this is what I want to stick this morning. You existed before your mother's womb. before, let's say it another way. Before your mother was born, before your grandmother was born, before your great-grandmother was born, God knew you. That's what he told Jeremiah. You existed before you came into existence. We were with God in eternity past. And I'm going to tell you one more thing about that. Your spirit knows it. Your spirit man knows. Your spirit man has memory of that reality. Your spirit man, that's why your spirit cannot be satisfied with nothing from this world. To your spirit, the things of this world is meaningless. The Bible said in Ecclesiastes that God has placed eternity in our heart. You almost pray for me. Please, I need to preach the gospel. Please pray for me. I need to quit what I'm doing and full attention to the preaching of the gospel. It is a moment like this, I sense it. Your spirit man knows something that your brain doesn't know. Your spirit man is conscious of a reality that your brain is yet to learn. Your spirit came from God, literally. Yeah, you know when God put your spirit in your body? When you were conceived. From the moment of conception, your spirit entered that whatever it looked like in that liquid form. During the process of knitting, that's why you read Psalm 139, David says, I was curiously wrought in the secret places. He saw my substance. He referred to himself in his mother's womb as substance. He said, you saw my frame, you knew my shape. Go read Psalm 139. David described the whole aspect of a human being developed in the womb of his mother. And he said, right there, you formed me. You formed, when I was curious, the wrought in the secret place, you saw my frame, you knew my shape. Because that was when God placed the spirit of man in the formation of man. Don't play with that. You see a woman pregnant, don't joke and play around with her. She's in God's workshop. I'm telling you, the Bible said the fruit of the womb is his reward. These things are, listen to me, these things you hear me saying, they're all in the, it's in the Bible. It's there. You and I existed with God before we were conceived. It's called eternity past. We have no recollection of it, no memory. I'll tell you one more thing. Before God put your spirit in your body, your spirit came loaded with gifts, talents, and abilities. All that God wanted you to do on the earth was placed in your spirit before you got here. Before you were placed on the earth, God placed your spirit in your body. So when you landed in your body, you were born now as a baby. Inside of that baby is a spirit of man, spirit of God, spirit of the devil, spirit of man. The Bible speaks of three kinds of spirit. Spirit of man, angels are also spirit. But they talk about spirit of man, spirit of God, spirit of the devil. He specifically said the spirit of man. And God who formed the spirit of man in him. You get it now, right?
in the hands of an artist. Oh, like a brush in the hands of an artist. You took your turn like a brush in the hands of an artist. I am your masterpiece of thought before life ever started. You took your time on me.
Absolute beautiful song. Her name is Tasha Combs. I love this song. I've been listening to some songs from her for the past couple of days. I've been listening to some songs. My heart has been blessed. You are not an accident, and you're not a coincidence. You're not a buck up. You didn't show up on earth because some accident happened or some coincidence or some kind of something happened and you show up. No. Somebody. The immortal, eternal, immortal, invisible God, the only wise God, omnipotent, omnipresent, omniscient God, Jehovah, the creator of the ends of the earth, wanted you here. You are God's design, God's original. Nobody has your fingerprints, your retina print for the eye, your DNA. That is another something. God have mercy. Do you know what your DNA is? Your DNA, listen to this. Your DNA literally is operate like a computer that causes your body to function the way it's supposed to function. Your DNA is like a software inside your body that tells each part of the body what to do. It tells the eyes to see, the ears to hear. The DNA is... Oh God, what can I say? You see, in your computer, there's a thing called a chip. A microchip in the computer that tells the computer. When I press the key on the computer, it tells the computer what to do. There's a thing in you called DNA. It's a coded, intelligent, mysterious thing in your body that speaks to the rest of, to all of your body and tell your body what to do. And your DNA, nobody has the DNA you have. They have similar DNA but not the same. Think about that. Can you imagine this? Do you know that with inside of your spinal cord, there are nerves that runs in the middle of your spinal cord? The disc in your spine, you know, your middle of your back, right? There is a long string of disc bones, but they operate like disc, and they are hollow in the middle.
You took your time on.
They are hollow in the middle, and they're on top of one another. Maybe a nurse or a doctor could tell me how much of those discs. They're on top of one another in round, like a circle, like, but it's not circular literally, but it has a hollowness in the middle. Do you know that inside of those discs are nervous wiring, like a wire? It was like when a man wire a house. Yeah. Their nervous system, our nervous cords or string, whatever you want to call it, that runs in the middle of that disc, and those are the wiring that wire. Listen to this. They are nervous system that runs from the brain straight down to your toenail, to your small toe. And if something go wrong with the small toe, you buck that small toe, the nervous system get active and tell the brain something is wrong down there. You hear me? And then the whole body, the nervous system start communicating throughout the whole body. And so we got to go help the toe.
In the hands of an artist, I am your master.
Oh my God. Oh my God. You see what I'm doing here now? I'm just sharing with you what goes on in my head when I'm by myself. I'm relaxing. If I'm driving or I'm parking my car or I'm home chilling, these are the things sometimes that goes into my head, flow through, and I burst out laughing. Don't think I'm just doing this now. These are the stuff that goes on in my head. And I'm like, God, you're not easy. Can somebody say, Lord, you're not easy at all. Yes, in the disc, one on top of the other, they can move. They can literally move. That's why I have a thing called a doctor named chiropractor. He can make those discs move. But their nervous system, do you know that they are finding out now that a good percentage of your body is electricity? Do you know this? Do you know that the nervous system communicates throughout the body through electricity? Electrical waves flow through your nerves. It's literally current. Do you know that there's electricity in your body? You're walking around literally like a generator with electricity flowing through your body. Have you ever gone to touch something like a lock or something and you see fire gash off your fingers? They call it statics. There is electricity in your body. Your nervous system sends electrical waves through the wiring. Your body is literally wired in it with nervous system all over your body. And the brain control all of it. Oh God. What a good God. I left my glasses in the car. I want to read something for you. Please bear with me this morning. Don't trouble me. Let me talk. Leave me alone. Just please don't trouble me. Somebody say, Pastor Palmer, you're playing the song too long. Listen. When you come on over here, we as manna. We eating manna. Who cares how long we play the song? If it's working, let's work it.
In the hands of an artist, I am your masterpiece. A thought before life ever started, you took your time on me like the breath. In the hands of an artist,
I want you to listen to the words of this song. I thought before life ever started, you took your time on me. I want you to listen to this song. The title of the song is Royalty by Tasha Combs. The title of the song again is Royalty. When you have time, listen to the words of this song. I love it. I've been listening to these new songs for the past couple of days. You haven't heard from me. You made me on purpose, and I'm glad I am your favorite. This God, this good God, is amazing, absolutely awesome and amazing. This good, great God. You know, this scientist used to be an atheist. He doesn't believe in God, right? The true story. And the man said, when he went and studied the DNA, which is the root of human existence, the DNA controls the brain. The man says he changed his mind about God and start believing that there got to be somebody who put this together. And he used to be a man who don't believe that there is a God, But it's after he went and studied the DNA and see the intelligence that put this thing together. There's no way the DNA could be an accident or randomly come up by itself. Somebody very wise, very intelligent, had to design this. The man said, I changed my mind, and I now believe that God is. Know ye that the Lord is God. You must know. He that cometh unto God must believe that God is. The word is there mean exist. That God exists. You won't let the devil turn you into a fool. You could go ahead and help yourself. I ain't gonna listen to that liar. He believes the thing he's trying to tell me not to believe. Can you imagine that nonsense? The devil believes what he's trying to get me not to believe. And I must listen to him. This liar.
Like a brush in the hands of an artist. You took your time like a brush in the hands of an artist. I am your masterpiece. I thought before life ever started. You took your time.
Wonderful, wonderful, wonderful. Oh, absolutely wonderful Jesus. Can you imagine this? That I existed. You see, this is why I wanna, this is what provokes me to seek God. You knew me before I entered my mother's womb. You knew me. He said, Jeremiah, before I formed you, I knew you. One of these days, we're going to do a teaching on create, form, and make. We're going to teach on that. I'm going to show you that those three words are not there by accident. Three different words, but it's speaking of three different things, or three different moments in time. We get there. But I'm very much intrigued and fast. Has somebody ever told you, said to you, I have something to tell you, but I'm not telling you now. And when they said that to you, all they did do is to wake up your curiosity, you know, uncomfortably, you know, you want to know. That's what happened to me when I read scriptures like that. Before I formed you in the belly, I knew you. Think about it. What is it you know, Lord, that I don't know? God, you definitely know something that I don't know, because I just get up one day and I became aware of myself at a certain age. At a certain age, I became aware of myself. That's what the Bible says happened to Adam, you know? Adam became a living soul. You know what that means? He became aware of himself. There was a time when Adam was just mud laying down there in the dirt. There was no life in him. But when God breathed, he became a living soul. What does that mean? It means something. It means he became aware of himself. He became conscious. The same thing happened to you and I at a certain age. At one day whole, you have no awareness of yourself. Yet you're alive. Screaming and crying, kicking and bawling for feeding and change my nappy and all that stuff you're going on with. You have no memory of it. 5 months old, you're alive and kicking. You're even laughing and smiling and everybody poodle, poodle, coodle, coodle you. You have no memory of it. At 1 year old, you're fully, you're up and kicking now. You start stepping around the house, you start walking, stop creeping. but you have no memory of it. Somewhere between 2 and 4 years old, you became aware of your... That's why I always ask people, do you remember your first thought? Do you remember, you, as far back... If I say to you now, and I'm not rushing, please, please, I'm not rushing, I'm calm, I'm just talking. If I should say to you now, go back in your memory and tell me your first thought, the first thing you remember in your mind, as far back as you can go when you were a child, go way back and tell me your very first time you became aware of yourself. What is that thought that you remember as far back as you can go as a child? That was the day you became aware of yourself.
You took your turn like a brush in the hands of an artist. I am your masterpiece, a font before life ever started. You took your time on me. I'm royalty. My father is king. I believe I am yours.
much to gain to lose. Too much to gain. Too much to gain. There's just too much to gain.
The bank of a wide raging river, trusting that I'd get across. And I've made my way through some valleys and deserts, believing I'd never get lost. I stood at the foot of what felt like Mount Everest, knowing I'd have the strength for the climb. It's through every trial, each test and temptation, there's one thing is sure every time. Over and over, again and again, God is faithful. Over and over, again and again, through it all. I have no hesitation, God does what he says he will do. Well, I'd simply say every battle has taught me there's nothing he won't help me through. So why should I dwell on the hardships and struggles when I look just beyond them I see? The way this will end is with great celebration, and deep in my heart I believe. Over and over, again and again, God is faithful. Over and over, again and again, through it all, he's made me able.
Everybody, I'm 28 minutes after 8 o'clock. Good morning to you. 28 minutes after 7 o'clock in Jamaica. Pleasant good morning, everybody. What a beautiful, beautiful, beautiful songs of Zion. Easy, cool, and breezy. On the whole ship of Zion this morning. Thank you.
when you're up on the mountain and you've got peace of mind like you've never known. But then things change and you're down in the valley. Listen, don't lose faith, for you're never alone. For the God on the mountain is still God in the valley when things go wrong. He'll make them right. God of the good time is still God in the bad time, the God of the day is still God in the land. Oh, you talk of faith. Mountain, oh, but talk comes so easy when life's at its best. Oh, but it's down in the valley of trials and temptations, 'cause that's where faith is.
There talk of faith when you're up on the mountain. You see, talk comes so easy when life's at its best, but it's down in the valley of trials and temptation. That's when faith is really put to the test. Before the God on the mountain is still God in the valley. When things go wrong, He'll make them.
Absolutely beautiful song. Beautiful song. At 24 minutes to the hour of 7 o'clock there in Jamaica.
Sing. For the God on the mountain is still God.
That's 24 minutes. Sorry, now it's 23 minutes before 8 o'clock in Jamaica. 23 minutes before 9 o'clock here in New York. Good morning, good morning. It's Manna in the Morning. Pastor Howard Palmer here with you. In a sweet, sweet gospel mood this morning. Sweet gospel mood. And I apologize for the past couple of days I've not been able to be with you because of my job situation. All right, so I was hindered for the past 3 days. But don't worry. Get it all straightened out so I can be with you in the mornings without any breakage. You know, this is something going on here. We can't let nothing come and interrupt it, all right? Gotta keep it going. When you got something real good going, you gotta keep it going. But it's keep on keeping on. Mercy. Whomever you are, wherever you are, the blessing of God Jehovah rest upon you. From the crown of your head to the soles of your feet. Good morning, New York.
For the God on the mountain is still God in the valley. When things go wrong, He'll make them right. The God of the good times is still God in the bad times. The God of
the gospel is the sweetest thing on earth. The gospel is the sweetest thing on earth.
When things go wrong, He'll make them right. The God of the good times is still God in the bad times. The God of the day is still God.
rose bush, and I tended it with care. Its buds began to blossom, their sweet fragrance filled the air. But the winter came, weather, the petals drooped and fell to the ground. My heart's ache as it faded, but I'd forgotten who had made it. And he said, roses will bloom again, just wait and see. And don't mourn what might have been, only God knows how and when. Loving wife of 40 years, he cherished every day they had, and he held the memories dear. He never dreamed he'd bury love and go on to live alone. When he lay his rose to rest, he looked to heaven, tried his best to believe that roses will bloom again. Just wait and see, and don't mourn what might have been. Only God knows how and when that roses will bloom. Rose of Sharon, broken and bruised in cruel shame. Stain the cross.
I wonder if you love these songs as much as I do.
So that men,
it put me in such a sweet, beautiful mood. Oh my God.
Here as he died, while Mary and the others,
roses will bloom again.
God kept a promise only he could keep. Roses will bloom again, just wait and see. And don't mourn what might have been, only God knows how and when that roses will bloom.
I told you, the musical maestro is here this morning.
Well, I'm going to a city. Oh, where the streets go. They say the tree of life right there is blooming beside that crystal water. And the roses never, never fade.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. Yes, Jesus.
My man.
Where the roses never, never fade.
Of God, no matter what hell you're going through, don't miss heaven. You hear me? No matter how much struggle and problem and pain you're going through in your life, do not miss heaven. Live your life to see God and to be with Him forever and forever. You hear me? Please, I beg you. Please, I beg you. Do not miss heaven. By the help of God assisting me, I'm going to take it from the top one more time. Don't let no botheration or troubleration trouble you. You hear me? No botheration or troubleration.
I'm going to a city. Where the streets go lane, and they say the tree of life right there is blooming beside that crystal water. And the roses never, never fade. But I want to tell you about it now.
Program is Manna in the Morning every weekday morning, Monday to Friday, 5 a.m. to 8 a.m. Jamaica time, 6 to 9 a.m. New York time, the East Coast of the United States of America. Good morning, my name is Pastor Howard Palmer. The blessing of God be with you.
Of white or red. it now, children. Lord, it seems like all the beauty so swiftly is decayed. Where the roses never, never fade.
Where the roses never fade.
Clean like a mighty rushing stream. Sweet, so sweet, anointing, pouring out the oil and wine all over. Just the touch of the hand of the precious Jesus, dipped into the oil of the Holy Ghost. It will soothe all my fears, wipe away all my tears. It's the anointing, oh, that I need, oh, sweet. Anointing flowing down to make me clean like a mighty rushing stream. Sweet, so sweet. Pouring out the oil and wine all over me.
Now we lift. We lift our hands unto the Heavenly Father. Send forth rain upon this dry, this thirsty, this barren land. All our sins, please forgive. Give us life that we may start to live. Let us feel the touch of your anointed hand on God. Like a mighty rushing stream, sweet, oh so sweet, anointing, pouring out the oil and wine.
Thursday morning, the 19th day of August 2021, Pastor Howard Palmer here with you. The program is Manna in the Morning. The blessing of God rest upon you. From the crown of your head to the soles of your feet, His anointing will surround you, His blessings will enfold you, and the peace of God that passes all understanding will get a hold of your heart and mind. We're cruising all the way up to 10 o'clock this morning. Yay, we're going to go all the way up to 10 a.m., which will be 9 a.m. for you there in Jamaica. Trying to make up for the first hour that we missed. But on this morning, I want you to enjoy the blessings of God in your heart. Jesus, just the mention of your name right here on Manna in the Morning.
Jesus, just the mention of your name flowers grow, the desert blooms again.
Yes, it does.
Like fire in winter cold, like precious gold. Jesus, just the mention of your name Jesus, just the mention of your name.
That precious name.
Flowers grow, the desert blooms again.
Oh yes,
like fire in the cold, like pure precious gold, Jesus. Just the mention of your name.
Like a lighthouse,
like a lighthouse
to a sailor in the midst of a midnight storm. You know, it's like a harbor.
Oh, hallelujah, hallelujah.
To an old ship that's
glory to
battered
God, hallelujah.
And torn.
Jesus, we love you, Lord. We praise your holy name, Lord.
It's like bread.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
To a
you're starving in
the heart. Yes, Lord, yes, Lord. Like Eli, we
fresh running water.
We honor and adore you, Lord.
Jesus, just the mention of your name. Yes, Lord. Jesus, just the mention of your name. Flowers grow, the desert blooms again. Oh yes, like fire in winter cold, it's like pure precious gold.
Jesus,
Jesus, my Jesus, just the mention of your name.
Jesus,
Jesus,
just the mention.
Precious, precious name.
Flowers grow.
Flowers grow.
The desert blooms again.
Oh, yes, it does. Like fire in winter cold.
It's like pure precious gold.
Jesus,
oh Lord, oh Lord,
just the mention of your name. Jesus, just the mention of your name. Jesus, just the mention, thank God, of your precious name.
Just the mention of your name.
Jesus.
I want to read for you this morning Psalm 139. Psalm 139. Psalm 139. Left my glasses in the car on the outside. And so I'm gonna try and see how much of this I can read for you. Psalm 139. It says, O Lord, thou hast searched me and know me. Thou knowest my down sitting and my uprising. Thou hast understandest my thoughts afar off. Thou compass my path and my lying down, and art acquainted with all my ways. For there is not a word in my tongue, but lo, O Lord, thou knowest it altogether. You know what I'm going to say before I say it. Thou hast beset me behind and before, and laid thy hand upon me. Such knowledge is too wonderful for me. It is high. I cannot attain unto it. The knowledge that God knows everything about me. Whither shall I go from thy spirit? Or whither shall I flee from thy presence? Whither shall I go from thy spirit? And whither shall I flee from thy presence? If I ascend up into heaven, thou art there. If I make my bed in hell, behold, thou art there. If I take the wings of the morning and dwell in the utmost part of the sea, even there shall thy hand lead me, and thy right hand shall hold me. If I say, surely the darkness shall cover me, even the night shall be light before me. Yea, the darkness hideth not from thee, but the light shineth as the day. But the night, shineth as the day,
and the darkness and the light are both alike unto thee. There's no difference between darkness and light where God is concerned. Night and day doesn't make no difference. God can still see you. That's what he's saying. For thou hast possessed my reins. Thou hast covered me in my mother's womb. You have possessed my reins, my existence. You possess it. My life is in your hand. You covered me from in my mother's womb. I will praise thee, for I am fearfully and wonderfully made. Marvelous are thy works, and that my soul know it right well. My substance was not hid from thee. My substance, my liquid form, when I just, you know, conception, our conception as human being was once in liquid form. It's like you look at the chicken, a white fowl walking up and down. That fowl was once liquid in the form of an egg. See? Human beings were once in liquid form. Imagine this. My substance was not hid from thee. And when I was made in the secret, when I was made in secret and curiously wrought in the lowest parts of the earth, I was put together in secret. Before my mother knew that she was pregnant with me, you knew that I was in her womb. I was curiously wrought in secret. Thine eyes did see my substance. He keeps saying that word substance. My liquid form. He's emphasizing it. Anytime you see the Bible repeat something twice, he wants you to pay attention to it. Thine eyes did see my liquid form, my substance. Yet being unperfect, I wasn't yet developed. I wasn't developed yet. I was in the development stage. I want you to hear me this morning. Can we worry about this and worry about that and stress over this and stress over that? This is the thing that should occupy our minds. We should have a solid knowledge of these things. That we, he said, know ye that the Lord is God. It is he that hath made us and not we of ourselves. We must never forget that we didn't make ourselves. God made us. He said, thine eyes did see my liquid form, my substance. I want you to think about what I'm saying to you. Before, listen to what it says. Yet being unperfect, which means I was unformed, I was undeveloped, I was not formed. I don't want to say deformed, because we was being developed, we was being formed. But there were stages where we were not fully formed. We were being knit, we were being put together. Bible said God saw it. God saw it. And if you're watching me this morning and you're pregnant and you're worried about bringing the baby into the world and the devil telling you to abort your baby, don't do it. Because God is looking at that child being formed. And he is there assisting the formation of that child. Yet being imperfect, and in thy book all my members were written. What does that mean? He said, in thy book all my members, the members of my body, was written down in the book of God. What does that mean? It means that God had a design in his mind as to what he want me to look like. That's what it means. God had a blueprint in his mind of what he wanted me to look like. So he was allowing adjustments to take place in my frame. I'm telling you what the Bible is trying to tell us. These things are not just written for the sound of it or poetic verses. Like you put someone write a poetry and they put nice poetic verses and sentences. This is not that case. This is the word of God. He said, yet being unperfect, and in thy book all my members were written. It simply means God had a design, what he wanted me to look like. That's what it means. And he was fashioning me based on the outcome he wanted for me to look like. All my members were written in that book, which in continuance were fashioned when as yet there was none of them. Which in continuance were fashioned. So before my feet became feet, God was seeing to it that that process go through. Do you see what the man David is saying? He's saying God was there making sure that it turned out exactly how he wanted it to be. Verse 17, he said, how precious also are thy thoughts unto me, O God. How great is the sum of them. If I should count them, they are more in the number than the sand. When I awake, I am still with thee. He said, how great are thy thoughts, O precious are thy thoughts unto me, O God. How precious are thy thoughts unto me, O God. The man is saying God is thinking precious thoughts concerning me. I preached a message along that line some years ago. How precious are thy thoughts unto me, O God. God is thinking precious concerning me. So who are you to think nasty about me and talk nasty about me? Who are you? God is thinking precious thoughts are concerning you and I. You should think about that. These are the things that should occupy your mind. Do you understand? How precious are thy thoughts unto me, O God? God, you're thinking beautiful and wonderful thoughts concerning my life. See, this is where self-esteem comes from. What they call self-esteem, this is where it comes from. You seeing God's mind and heart towards you from his word. That's where self-esteem comes from. You can't read this and believe it and still thinking less of yourself. There's no way possible you could read this and believe it and think less of yourself. If I should count them, they are more in number than the sand of the sea. So more than the sand. When I awake, I'm still with thee. Verse 19. Surely thou wilt slay the wicked, O God. Depart from me, therefore, ye bloody man. He will slay the wicked. For they speak against thee wickedly, and thine enemies take thy name in vain. Say, do not I hate them, O Lord, that hate thee? And am I not grieved with those that rise up against thee? I hate them with perfect hatred. I count them mine enemies. Then verse 22 and 23. Verse 22, verse 23. Hear what he said. Search me, O God, know my heart. Try me and know my thoughts. And see if there be any wicked way in me, and lead me in the way everlasting. I wanted to read that for you today, Psalm 139, to show you that that David understood that his existence originated with God. His existence originated with God. That is the root of it. This is why in today's world, evolution is trying to erase your belief in God. If once you take away from a man his belief in God, his faith in God, you have destroyed that man. This man is going to become a wreck eventually, because that is the foundation of your existence. How are you going to remove the root from the tree and expect the tree to still stand up there and still become a fruitful tree? It will never be. If you remove the root from the tree is a dead tree. Dead. The moment you get rid of the root is the moment the tree dies. Because the root is what keeps the tree in the ground, and the root is what keeps the tree alive. It stabilizes the tree in the ground, and it feeds the tree with what the nourishment the tree needs. If you remove the root from the tree, the tree is going to die. It's not if. It's a matter of when. The devil is a liar. We give God all the praise.
I shudder to think what would have happened to Jimmy Swaggart. My parents had not found Jesus Christ, but mercy rewrote my life. For years I traveled a road all wrong. My heart had lost its joy and its song. Then grace placed me right where I belong. When mercy mistakes that day returned into miracles. He reached up and wiped away the tears and turned them somehow into joy. My past sins were forgiven, a new name was written. God, yes it did.
But we serve the Most Most High God. There is nothing like you, Jehovah.
You are the Most High.
Come on.
You are the Most High God.
Giving God all the praise this morning. I hope you don't mind. The time now is 23 minutes to the hour. We're going all the way up to 10 o'clock this morning. All right, everybody. The program is Manna in the Morning. Pastor Howard Palmer here with you. Good morning, good morning, good morning. Whomever you are, wherever you are, the blessing of God rest upon you. Mercy.
You are the Most High.
It's the mood I'm in this morning, musically. Musically. Mercy. Giving God the glory. Giving God the praise. Yeah, yeah, yeah. All right, all right. Come the man, come the man.
They are the works of men.
Dear God from Zion,
you are the Most High God.
You know, some years ago I went into Israel and we were in the area of the Wailing Wall in Jerusalem in a line getting ready to go on the Temple Mount. You got to stand on a very long line. But there were worshippers, Jewish worshippers, going in and out of the area. There's a place there called the Wailing Wall where they go and keep their various praise and celebration services. And you have different Jewish sect, you know, different, like a different church organization, right? Something like that. So I remember I was standing in line. Pastor Hume was with me in line. We're getting ready to go on top of the Temple Mount where they say the temple was built, right? And I heard a group of Jewish worshippers coming from the Wailing Wall area, like they were heading home, but they were in a band. And they were dancing and playing the drums. God be my helper. They were dancing, and when I saw them, they looked to me like, it's as if I was looking on Bible days. They dressed that way. They sound a certain way. And people, as God is my witness, I didn't plan to do this. But when they came close to where I was, I lost it. Them. I joined the crowd, and these people, when they dance in a circle. So guess what they did? Guess what they did? They all were so happy to see me join them. They formed a ring around me and left me alone in the ring. God have mercy. It was too late. I had to give it to them.
We're singing, you are the Most High God.
Somebody give him praise.
Are you ready to praise Jesus? Come on, somebody celebrate him. Hey! Come on, somebody.
All the other gods, they are the works of men. But you are the Most High God. There is no
beautiful, what a beautiful. It's amazing how 3 hours flew by very fast. Thank you to everybody that has joined me. Again, I sincerely apologize for not being with you for the past 3 mornings. I did try, believe me, I did. You gotta see with me now. Thank you again, everybody. Beautiful morning, beautiful morning. Wonderful. Ay, ay, ay. Mercy. Oh, the glory of His presence. The glory of His majesty. I want you to have a blessed day today. As you go through the course of the day, you should know you're not an accident or a coincidence. I'm going to entitle this tape, this videotape, No Accident, No Coincidence. A designer's original, divinely designed, a designer's original. No accident, no coincidence. I'm divinely designed, a designer's original. Good morning to you. Mercy at 9:45 here in New York, 8:45 in Jamaica, 19th day of August 2021. The program is Manna in the Morning. Pastor Howard Palmer here with you, and I'm here to tell you things are already better. Already better. Mercy. No accident, no coincidence. A designer's original, divinely designed, made in the image of God. Destinies on my life, purposes on my life. Come with me now, man. Come with me. Come with me. Telling you, man, I love every minute of it. Hey, glory, glory. Don't forget. This Friday, tomorrow night, Saturday and Sunday night, 3 nights of heaven and earth camp meeting. We are having a 3-night meeting in aid of launching our ministry app. We're officially launching the ministry app. Starting tomorrow night, Friday, Saturday, and Sunday night. 8953 Francis Lewis Boulevard, House of Prayer, Pastor A. Blake. We're using his facilities over there. Thank you, Pastor Blake. I want you to join me this Friday night, Saturday and Sunday night. Mercy, mercy. The word of the Lord is going to come hot. I mean, hot. We are going to do everything in our power to stream it live on the internet. We're going to be streaming it live on the internet. So we want you to get ready for that, all right? Yes, you are. I'm telling you, man. I tell you, I got some music for you. I got some music for you. So for those of you that live in the New York area, I'm inviting you to come join us. Friday night, Saturday night, 7 o'clock, Sunday night. Yay, yay, yay. Heaven and earth, hand clapping, foot stamping, Holy Ghost, camp meeting. We're camping out under the glory spout, where the glory comes out. I am telling you, a pillar of cloud by day, a pillar of fire by night, mercy. Are you ready? Are you ready? Holy Ghost, hand clapping, foot stamping, devil chasing, Holy Ghost revival. 3 nights camping out under the glory, under the glory cloud, where the glory comes out. Looking forward to see you there. Hey! Mercy! Lord God, help me! God, help me! For those of you in Jamaica and around the world, we are doing our best to stream the services live on the internet, alright? We're doing our best to stream it live for you so you can watch it. Alright, as a matter of fact, today we're going by the church to do a test run to make sure it works, alright? My soul and all that is within me, bless his holy name. I promise you. Hey! Tomorrow morning, I'm going to be with you. If I have to sleep on the air, right here on my chair, I'm going to be here, I promise you. Dear God from Zion. Boy. Dear God. Tomorrow morning, I catch you tomorrow morning, all right? Dear God, I'm hooked. The music got me. The truth busting on my head. I will catch you tomorrow morning. Good morning, everybody. The blessing of the Lord rests upon you. I gave you an extra hour this morning because we missed the first hour, right? So we extended the time to 10 o'clock. I'll catch you tomorrow morning, 5 a.m. Jamaica time, 6 a.m. New York time. We'll be back with you. Until then, Pastor Howard Palmer saying to you, it is in the pursuit of God. Purpose and destiny for a man's life is discovered. We love you. We'll be right back.
love is through every pore.
Your love is through
every pore.